This is the place. What was Lafreniere so interested in?
Get him upstairs, quickly.
Latouche, old friend. You do get about, don't you?
Run off the part where I spill your gut. Oh, oh. Ah, let go of me. Please. Why are you doing that? Where is she? I know you have her hidden from me. You think I can't find out? I'll talk to you.
Where is he? Shit! I better keep my eyes open. Jeez!
Stay sharp. Something's going on.
Stay sharp.
Hey, you hit her! Die!
Well now, didn't just up and vanish now, did you?
Oh well, got better things to do anyway.
If you're smart, you'll let it lie.
What's that supposed to mean?
Just that some folk don't like people prying into their affairs. Savvy?
Did he just...
It was a crime worthy of death under Tiberius to praise Brutus. Caligula condemned to death those who were so sacrilegious as to undress before the image of the emperor. Once tyranny invented the crime of injured majesty, which were actions either indifferent or heroic. Who could have dared to think that it merited a punishment more gentle than death without rendering himself guilty of the same crime? When fanaticism, born of the monstrous union between ignorance and despotism, invented in its turn the crime of sacrilege.
I do have a business
in its delirium, avenging God himself. Was it not necessary that they offer him blood and bring him down to their level? The monsters who said
the plan is still too general. And let's not forget that Lafreniere is still out there somewhere, waiting to burn us all at the stake.
Tom, you haven't heard yet then.
Heard what?
Well, Lafreniere is dead. Hours ago, in fact. Assassins.
That seems convenient.
That's the thing about assassins. Point them at a Templar conspiracy and they ask no questions. All right for the killing. Predictable that way. Come, we'll fetch the captain and get started.
Need an answer, friend. No need to make this any harder, eh? Tick tock, mate. It's a simple question. Just tell me what I want to know. Speak up.
Are you finished?
Near enough. Now here's the thing. I can go on like this all day. But you got an hour left in you?
Two at the most. Half if I bring out the sharp bits.
So why not skip the end game and go directly to me? Tell me where it is, and all this can be over.
Oh,
what was that?
Jumbo.
You're a smart man.
Roy, clean up your mess, it's time.
Be right there. You heard the weasel, boys?
Really throw him out the window.
Trash belongs in the gutter.
Sloppy. Someone might have seen.
Who? My boys are watching the whole place. They'll deal with any good Samaritans.
They'd better. The Grandmaster won't be happy if the whole plan comes unraveled because of one dead peon.
You were right. King Louis's been talking to all those he shouldn't have. Plotting against the one side of the mouth while he promises to support the Constitution on the other.
I trust you can get this information into the proper hands of both of you.
Of course, Grandmaster. With this evidence in hand, the king's conviction is certain.
I told you I can make him talk.
You've done well, Captain. Marie?
Starve them. Through famine and fury, they will see their false masters for what they are, but do it gradually. Too quickly and will draw the wrong sort of attention, yes?
What you're asking will take at least a year, Grandmaster, if not two.
The great work requires patience, my friend. If Paris must suffer a while longer so the world might be remade, then so be it.
Why not just kill him and be done with it? One of my boys, a knife, a dark hallway. Easy peasy.
We want a condemned man, Captain, not a martyr. Have patience.
Respectfully, Grandmaster, patience is well and fine. But the longer we wait, the greater the chance of discovery.
Well, the assassins already found Sivert and the Wadetun.
Oh, Sivert and Loire already served their purpose. Their destruction, while inconvenient, is no obstacle. And the assassins have already proved useful when properly led.
What about the Delacer brat? She could be dangerous if she manages to rally the old guard.
That situation will be resolved.
How so?
Mademoiselle Delacer will soon be on her way to l'Hôtel Voisin, eager to speak with Monsieur Lafreniere. Sadly, Monsieur Lafreniere has nothing left to say.
Please.
Clever, Grandmaster. You've had your brush with the assassins as well. Respectfully, you won't always be so lucky.
Quite right.
I shall leave the execution of our work to you good, ladies and gentlemen. For my part, I can return to thank you.
I'll see the watch triples.
Very well. May the Father of Understanding guide you.
May the Father of Understanding guide us.
Go on, we'll lock up down here and go for a pint.
Watch the exits. The spy will be making a run for it.
The spy's still here.
No spies escaping on my watch.
fight! Seems we have a spy, boys.
You're not ears things now, am I?
No spies escaping on my watch.
Wild geese and all.
Right. Back to the shop.
Find the spy.
Hang about.
Don't let the spy escape! Shit! I've got ya! Is that your top speed?
Lovely speech. Quiet. The man's a visionary.
Abolish the death penalty. Next you'll be saying we should do away with branding.
Captain!